हरि ओम, वेलकम बैक टू स्टोरी टाइम। टुडे लेट्स हियर एन इंटरेस्टिंग एपिसोड फ्रॉम द महाभारत। एंड दिस वाज द टाइम व्हेन दैट माइटी भीमा, द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट ऑफ ऑल द पांडवास, हिमसेल्फ ले हेल्पलेस। सो हाउ डिड दिस हैपन? इट वाज द टाइम व्हेन द पांडवास अलोंग विद द्रौपदी वर इन एक्साइल। एज दे रोम्ड अबाउट इन द वेरियस फॉरेस्ट, they came to a place known as Vishakayupa. This was a beautiful forest and Bhima once set off. He wanted to enjoy the scenic beauty and also go hunting. And with his heavy feet, he went stomping about into the forest where great mighty trees were also uprooted and the huge rocks and boulders were set off rolling. As he went deeper and deeper into the forest, suddenly the atmosphere changed. It became dark. The water in the pool became brackish or black. And suddenly in front of him, there was a huge crater. And coiled within the crater was a huge python. But before Bhima could collect himself, he was entwined within the python's grasp. And Bhima, the one who had the strength of 10,000 elephants, was now helpless. As the python coiled around him, Bhima started feeling himself becoming weaker and weaker. He looked into the eyes of the python and felt a strange kind of lethargy coming within him. And so he asked the python, "Who are you? I have never been defeated by anybody, and why do I feel so weak when I look at you?" And the python answered, "I am Nahusha. I am your ancestor, and I am now a python because of a curse. Listen, O Bhima, listen to my story. I was the son of Ayu, who himself was the son of Nahusha Chakravarti. And I was noble, righteous, walking on the path of Dharma, worshipping all the deities. And after performing more than 100 Ashwamedha Yagnas, once I was invited to become the king of the Devatas and rule in heaven. Now, I obliged because I was worshipful towards all the Devatas. And when they asked me, I could not refuse. After I became their king, they also gave me that Amrit, the nectar of immortality. And Brahmaji blessed me that whoever looked into my eyes would lose their strength. And so I ruled Swargalok. But soon, that ego, which is the evil enemy of everybody, started rising within me. And I began to think, I am the king of the Devatas, why do I need to worship them anymore? And so, in that foolish, deluded state of mind, I ordered all the Devatas, the great Agni, Vayu, Surya Dev, to become my attendants. And not only that, such a fool that I was, I made the holy sages carry me on the palanquins. And one day, lost in that stupor and intoxication of pride and ahankara, one day I kicked one of the sages, the holy noble Agastya Rishi, asking him to move on faster, telling sarpa, sarpa, which means faster, faster. But I had pushed my luck too far, and the mighty sage cursed me. He said, "May you become a sarpa," for sarpa also means snake. Immediately I fell down from the heavens. I asked for forgiveness and mercy. And the compassionate sage said, "You will have to wait a great many years before you are released from the curse. You lie down in that forest as a python till one day a holy, noble, righteous king who is also a philosopher will come there. When he answers your questions rightly, you will be released from the curse." And so it is that I am now waiting here in the forest. I have been also blessed by Brahmaji that whoever comes within my grasp in the 1/6th hour of the day shall become my meal, and so I shall not leave you. Now, the great Bhima, he accepted this without even a trace of sorrow. He said, good and bad, happiness and sorrow comes to a person based on their actions or karma. So I do not mind the fact that I will soon become your meal. But I feel sad for my brothers who in their grief of losing me will no longer fight this war, and they will not be able to punish those adharmic cousins of mine. Also, I feel sad for my mother who is sure to grieve over the loss of her son. And saying thus, he was about to become the meal of Nahusha the serpent. Meanwhile, however, back in the hermitage, Yudhishthira started feeling uneasy and anxious. And so he asked Draupadi, where is Bhima? I cannot see him. And Draupadi answered, Bhima had gone long back into the forest. Immediately, Yudhishthira decided to set out in search of Bhima. And so telling Arjuna to look after Draupadi and Nakula and Sahadeva to look after all the accompanying Brahmins, Yudhishthira along with their priest Daumya decided to look out for Bhima. They followed his mighty footprints and soon came to the spot where Bhima lay held tightly within the coils of that serpent. Now Yudhishthira calmly folded his hands and begged the serpent to release his brother. He told the serpent, allow me to offer some other animal as replacement for my brother, but leave him. And the serpent said, no, you listen to my story. It is meant to be that whoever comes into my grasp at this time of the day becomes my meal. If you wait here, tomorrow you shall become my meal too. However, if you answer my questions rightly, I will let your brother go. And so now Yudhishthira was ready for this. And so Nahusha asked him, tell me, who is a Brahmin? And what is that highest knowledge which one should gain in this world to become free from sorrow? And Yudhishthira answered, he was after all Dharmaraja. He knew everything about Dharma and right living. And so he said, a Brahmin is one who has purity, who speaks the truth, who follows good conduct, who is charitable, and who believes in non-violence. As for the highest knowledge, the only knowledge which makes one free from sorrow is knowledge of Paramatma, the Supreme. Now the serpent asked him, so then is there no meaning of birth or the caste? And Yudhishthira said, yes, a caste cannot be determined by birth. It is only determined by one's nature, and so whoever has this nature or the traits of purity, truth, ahimsa, good conduct ought to be called a Brahmin. And if not, he will be one of the lowest or a Shudra. Now, Nahusha was very happy, for Yudhishthira answered all these and many more questions perfectly. And Nahusha immediately said, I release your brother. And I too now am freed from this curse thanks to you. And saying that, from the serpent form emerged the kingly form of Nahusha. And soon, folding his hands in gratitude and blessing his descendants, he ascended to heaven. While Yudhishthira, Bhima and the Rishi Daumya retraced their steps back to the rest of their family. So this was one more instance in the Mahabharata that the brain proved superior to brawn. May this story inspire us to realize that everybody's personality is shaped by their nature and their actions and not merely by birth. I hope you liked today's story, and if you did, Do subscribe to the channel and share the story with your family and friends. And I will be back with another story next Thursday. Until we meet again, Hari Om.